In this video, I'm gonna show you how to boost your bass volume on Windows 10. First, I'm gonna show you how to use the Windows built-in audio enhancement, but since that sometimes just doesn't work at all, I'm gonna show you some way better tools to boost your bass instead. This video will go over and cover 4 different software and 1 Chrome extension and a little bonus on VLC media player in the very end. Alrighty, so first I'm gonna show you Windows' own audio enhancement feature. The only problem with this is that it only works on very few output devices. But to access it, right-click on the speaker and open up your sound settings. And then you need to select whichever speaker you want to activate it on, which is probably already selected as your main device. Then go to Device Properties from the link, and then on the right side, go to Additional Device Properties. Now this will open up this little window, and you should see an enhancement tab in the middle at the top. And if you then tick the bass boost option and click apply, or you can click preview to see the see what it sounds like, and then you can just click OK and it will be added to your device. Now there is a very high likelihood that your audio device does not support this Windows enhancement. Not quite sure what causes that, but there's not much you can do to fix it, and considering the fact that it's not very customizable anyway, it's not the best option out there for your bass boosting needs. So this is why we're gonna go through some free and even a couple paid options to equalize and customize your sound as you want on Windows 10. The first tool, and in my opinion the best free tool available for you to boost your Windows bass volume, is called EqualizerAPO. Now, long story short, EqualizerAPO basically just installs onto a specific audio device and it gives you equalizer possibilities. But it also needs a separate graphical interface, which the Peace Equalizer extension is. So you have to download both of these, and you first have to install the EqualizerAPO and then install the Peace extension to it. After that, you'll be ready to roll. If you need to install EqualizerAPO on different audio devices, you can find the actual path of the installation by going to C, Program Files, and then EqualizerAPO. For some reason it didn't create a shortcut, at least for me, so I have to go through the entire path. And then you just open the configurator and you can see the check mark on which devices it is installed and which it can be installed on. And after that, just install the Peace interface, which I already did. And if you open it up, you will see first of all this prompt to see if you want to use the complex or the simpler UI. You always use the simpler one because it's easier to use. And from here you can see all kinds of cool presets on the left side, including the bass boost preset. Now I'm not sure if this is a feature or not, but every time I select a different preset from the list, the application kind of looks like it closes and starts up again. But either way, it saves the changes, and if you close the Peace interface, the changes will remain. You can easily keep changing these while you listen to music or whatever to hear the changes in real time, then you'll see if the changes are good enough for you. And if you close the app, the changes will be saved. Out of all the tools and methods I tested, this one gave me by far the best results when it comes to boosting bass, so I highly recommend you try this first. My second favorite equalizer for boosting bass on Windows after EqualizerAPO is called FxSound. Now straight up, this is not a free tool. It gives you a free version of it, which allows you to basically use the entire tool, but you cannot save your presets. So every time you restart your PC, you have to select the settings again. It costs about $20 a year, which is not a huge amount if you use a tool every day. But $20 is $20, so you definitely gotta give it a shot first to see if you like it more than any of the free alternatives on this list. But once you've downloaded and installed it, instantly you will see that the user interface on FxSound is way better looking. It's very modern and very easy to use. And it just opens up with this cool looking bunch of sliders and tools that you can just boost up the bass from there. And that's really all you need to do, and you'll hear the changes in real time as well while you listen to music, so you'll know. But these presets, as you can see, they're only for the full version. So it will tell you to upgrade to Pro if you wanna save or use any other presets. But you can still use these sliders and test it out with this on-off toggle on the free version. And there's also a compact little version, man. It will just stay in your toolbar, and it will also automatically start up with Windows if you want it. So I highly recommend you give this one a shot. It gave me the second best results as well, so it's definitely worth a shot. The third tool is not my favorite, but it's a free alternative, and it's probably one of the more popular ones. It's called Voicemeeter, or in this case Voicemeeter Banana, which is basically an advanced version of the normal Voicemeeter. Gives you a bit more options, and it's used for many things, not necessarily so much for equalizing your audio, but it works for boosting bass as well, which is kind of interesting. What you gotta do is download it and install it, as you might have expected, and then search up Voicemeeter in your search bar, and it will open up the interface. And then here all you need to do is bump up the little circle that says bass on it. And that's all you need to do. You should be able to hear the bass go up and down in real time while you listen to music if you have selected the Voicemeeter as your primary sound device. Now, it is definitely worth noting that the interface for everything else that you see here is not very easy to use, and if you want to get the most out of it, you can go to the Voicemeeter official website, and there's a lot of documentation and video tutorials listed on their official website. So if you actually want to make some more use out of this and equalize your devices way better, you can go check them out and see what you can actually do with this tool. It's very versatile, but maybe not the best option if you're only looking for a bass boost. Now for the final equalizer software, it's called Boom 3D, and it's also a paid software, but it does provide you a 30-day full features, no credit card required free trial, so definitely give it a shot. You can get it from Steam as well, and as you can see, it has very positive reviews, but I recommend getting the free trial from their official homepage. And you can also see it's very cheap for the permanent license, is like 10 bucks or something. It's a lot cheaper than FxSound, for example. And the only issue with this is I was not able to get as great of a boost in my audio as with the other tools. I'm not sure why, because it apparently should work very well. This is why I really need you to give it a chance yourself first. Just as you can see, the interface itself is very clean. It has tons of options and tons of presets, including bass boost, gaming, movies, all kinds of stuff. So really not much you need to change yourself here. You can also mess with all these sliders for every preset, and there's a lot of settings you can change, including hotkeys. So if you want to toggle different things on and off while playing games, for example. And there's even something called 3D surround in this, which I guess is kind of the selling point of this software, but I didn't really try it since I'm not using headphones for my testing on this. I used a separate soundbar, which could be the issue why I wasn't getting as good results from this software, but I'll leave it up to you to test this out. But definitely don't pay for it before you test out the trial first. Next up, moving on to a very epic browser extension, which sadly only works on Chromium browsers like Google Chrome and Brave browser. But you gotta go to the Google Play Store and look up Ears. It's called Ears. and once you've added it to the browser, it should show up on the top right as the yellow black symbol. And if it's not, then you gotta pin it separately to the top. You do want to have it pinned, since you're going to be clicking on it every time you want to boost something. Then just open up any tab with music, like YouTube or Spotify, or in this case Uppbeat, since it's got some royalty free music. Then just open up the extension and click on the bass boost button at the bottom of it. Did you hear the difference? I'm not sure if it plays up on YouTube videos, but This is very convenient, it's free, and there's no catch, so I highly recommend you try this if you like to bass boost YouTube videos or whatever else you might be listening to from your browser. Now, as a final fun little tidbit you might not know about, but you definitely heard about VLC Media Player, and it has its own built-in equalizer, which is very cool if you tend to watch movies or listen to old school MP3 files on your PC. All you need to do is open up your VLC Media Player and then press Ctrl and E to open up the equalizer in it. And then from there you just enable it, and there is a drop-down list full of presets that you can choose for your sound profiles. And you can pick up anything that will fit your music or your movies, including bass boosting, and then just save it and you're done. And that's all you need to do. Now make sure to leave any issues, comments, or suggestions in the comments below. I read all of them, and take it easy.